It's CES 2024. I am in the FIC booth. They are a Taiwanese supplier of display solutions. In particular, they're showing their AR HUD, the augmented reality HUD. This is based on laser beam scanning technology. So they have three lasers, red, green, and blue, and then a MEMS-based scanner. So this demonstration actually has two focal planes, a near field and a far field. All this is done with a single MEMS scanner and a single set of RGB lasers. It is a three mirror optical solution. This is still a prototype, but the near field is a 6 by 1 degree field of view with a virtual distance of 2.5 meters. The far field is 11 by 4 degrees with a virtual distance of 25. Meters. The current prototype is not too bad. It's bright, 10,000 nits or so. They say they can get up to 20,000. To 12,000 or so. And I asked them about kind of where they are in terms of commercialization. This is still a prototype. It is a rather large volume. I think it's about 20 liters. So they recognize that it needs to be smaller volume. So they are looking at some alternative solutions here to get rid of the three mirror system, in particular to go to a holographic optical element, an HOE, which would sit on the windshield of the car. It could, and they believe this HOE can have some optical power, so you can create at least one, maybe two virtual distances. Which is really what you need for an AR HUD. The components, of course, all these AR HUDs have to be use components that are automotive certified. They have the processor has been certified, the lasers have been certified, the MEMS scanner has yet to be certified. Now that's the most tricky part here, because a MEMS scanner is basically a little tiny mirror on ribbons. And it has to vibrate and move that way. So there's not much you can do to vibration isolate that part. So the package around it has to be physically isolated. So any kind of vibration in the car is obviously going to impact that MEMS scanner. So that's one of the difficulties of laser beam scanning in AR HUDs, is getting that vibration isolation. We'll take a look at the images in just a minute. I think that's most of what I know at this point. So let's take a look at the images. And here are some of the images in this HUD. You can see the near field is showing the speed, and I guess that's a distance, 10 kilometers. I've tried to adjust the camera so this doesn't, it's visible. And then in the far field, you can see it's kind of trying to trace some road paths for the driver. It is, as you can see, RGB, but there's clearly some issues with the image quality at this point. But again, this is a prototype at this point. So good progress for the company. Chris Chenock for Insight Media.